Today let us discuss what is pressure line or thrust line in the pre-stressed concrete. At any given section of pre-stressed concrete beam, the combined effect of the pre-stressing force P and the externally applied load, it will result in a distribution of concrete stresses that can be resolved into a single force. The locus of the points of application of this resultant force in any structure is termed as the pressure line or the thrust line. What it means, here in this beam we can see there is a pre-stressing force and there will be externally applied loads. Okay, both of them will result in the stresses in the concrete. Okay, and those stresses, they can be resolved into a single force, and at various section we will get the resultant force, different resultant force at various other sections. If we take the locus of the points of application of that resultant force in any structure, okay, then we will get this pressure line or the thrust line. Okay, and you always we find the pressure line or the thrust line by calculating the shift of the pressure line or thrust line, okay, from the cable line, and it is determined as the bending moment divided by the pre-stressing force. Means if you want to find the shift of the pressure line at the mid span, okay, then we have to find what will be the bending moment at mid of the section, and that bending moment divided by the pre-stressing force. Okay, and if you are finding at the quarter span, then the bending moment value at quarter span section divided by the pre-stressing force, then we will get the shift of the pressure line from the cable line. Okay, so this is pressure line or the thrust line. Next, let us see a simple numerical example on pressure line or thrust line. A pre-stressed concrete beam of section 120 mm wide by 300 mm deep is used over an effective span of 6 meters to support a uniformly distributed load of 4 kN per meter, which includes the self weight of the beam. The beam is pre-stressed by a straight cable carrying a force of 180 kN and located at an eccentricity of 50 mm. Determine the location of thrust line in the beam and also plot its position at quarter and central span sections. Okay, so first we have to write what is the given data. Given data, there is a pre-stressed concrete beam section 120 by 300, so rectangular section. Then pre-stressing force is 180 kN and they have given that this 4 kN per meter UDL includes the self weight. Okay, so W equal to 4 kN per meter and eccentricity is given as 50 mm. Okay, then we have to first calculate what is the area. Okay, so area is 120 by 300, we get 36,000 mm square. Then we have to find section modulus Z, that is 120 into 300 square by 6. For a rectangular section, it is BD square by 6. So B is 120, D is 300. So BD square by 6. So we get 1.8 into 10 to the power 6 mm cube. In last video, I have explained how to find the resultant stress. I have given a simple formula as well. Okay, how to remember. And we have to find the resultant stresses at the top fiber and bottom fiber, that is F superior and F inferior. If you remember, P by A minus plus P by Z plus minus M by Z, then done. You can find what is the resultant stresses. So pre-stressing force is 180 kN. So 180 into 10 to the power 3 divided by area is 36,000 minus P, 180 into 10 to the power 3 into eccentricity is 50 divided by section modulus is 1.8 into 10 to the power 6 plus this bending moment at center is WL square by 8. W is 4 into span is 6 meters. So 6 square by 8, we get 18 kN meter, substituting in Newton and mm because we want stress in Newton per mm square. So 18 into 10 to the power 6 divided by 1.8 into 10 to the power 6, we get 10 Newton per mm square. So this is F superior. then F inferior is P by A plus P by Z minus M by Z. Substituting similarly, we get 0. Okay, so this is at center of span. Okay, then next we have to find what is the shift of pressure line. That is M by P. The bending moment at center span is 18 into 10 to the power 6 divided by 180 into 10 to the power 3. That is precessing force. So we get 100 mm. So this is the shift of pressure line or thrust line from the cable line at center of the span. Okay. Next, we have to find what is the bending moment at the quarter span section. That is 3 by 32 WL square. W is 4 and span is 6 meters. So we get 3 by 32, 4 into 6 square. That is 13.5 kilonewton meter. Then finding F superior and F inferior. Okay, P by A minus P by Z plus M by Z. Okay, pre-stressing force, area, eccentricity, everything remains same. Only here section modulus also same. Only bending moment value changes. That is 13.5 into 10 to the power 6. So we get 7.5 newton per mm square. F superior at the quarter span section. Then F inferior, P by A plus P by Z minus M by Z. Okay, then we get 2.5 newton per mm square. Okay, then shift of pressure line from the cable line M by P, that is 13.5 into 10 to the power 6 divided by P, 180 into 10 to the power 3. We get 75 mm. So the location of the pressure line here at center, it is 100 mm. Okay, center of span, and at quarter span it is 75 mm. Okay, shift of pressure line from the cable line. So this is the cable line. Okay, so at center it is 100 mm, at quarter span it is 75 mm. Okay, so I have represented here the cable line, pressure line, and what is the shift of the pressure line, eccentricity and span of the beam. So you have to similarly draw the diagram at the end after finding all the resultant stresses and as well as finding the shift of the pressure line. Okay, so this is a very simple problem on pressure line.